Hello and welcome to Walk the Talk. I'm Shekhar Gupta in Delhi's Niti Bagh, the colony where the top lawyers live. And there isn't a top lawyer. In fact, there are not more than two or three in India for many decades, like Soli Sorabjee. Soli, I can say lion of the bar, or maybe the bubble share of the bar.
Both.
Both. So, as bubble share of the bar,
yeah.
How do you look at the state of the judiciary now?
Well, it's a mixed picture. Trouble is, judiciary sometimes, there is overreach, no doubt about it. It deals with matters which are not with the judicial sphere. But Shekhar, remember this, when there's continued neglect with the executive, then the judiciary has no option. It can't prevaricate. It can't throw over division, separation of powers theory and all that. But the thing is, there is no consistency.
Right.
Coherent nahi hai. The reason is there are different benches. You see, in America, Supreme Court, the court sits a bunk. Here, there are 12 benches having different mindsets. That creates confusion. And the trouble is about PIL, which is good, but it has certain problems.
So what are your problems with PIL?
First of all, people must realize that PIL, pill, is not a pill for every ill.
Right.
Now, problems are PIL degenerates into private interest litigation, political interest litigation, and publicity interest litigation.
Private interest litigation, personal interest litigation,
political interest litigation,
and publicity interest litigation.
That's right, publicity interest litigation. And that unfortunately affects everyone, including lawyers and judges.
Right.
They want to see their names there, they want to be seen.
So lawyers want publicity and judges want publicity.
Yeah. It's a human weakness with both share.
Right. So, will you give me some examples of this publicity interest litigations and genuine public interest litigations?
Well, publicity interest litigation is when you even entertain petitions like saying ban Sikh jokes.
Sikh jokes, yes.
And some movie, some people are not happy with certain scenes, so you ban it and you give a good lecture about what should be done or not done. That's not your sphere.
And then hold a show to watch, like Bombay High Court did, I think, for Uttar Punjab.
That's a bit. But Shekhar, remember this, all said and done, even the common citizen still has confidence in the judiciary.
Yes.
If there's any importance, matter of public importance, they want to retire sitting Supreme Court judge.
Yeah. That's why it is that much more important that judiciary is protected.
Oh yes.
And judiciary, but does judiciary need protecting from the executive, from the bench, or from itself?
From itself.
From itself. So elaborate on that.
You see, from itself meaning it must behave up, evolve a coherent policy about its intervention in certain matters. Different benches that intervene in different matters, then really it brings down the image of the judiciary. Then it becomes a target of criticism, but legitimately so.
And ridicule.
Of course, ridicule by some people. But the thing is, Shekhar, what do? Judges are not given the divine gift of infallibility.
Right.
They have weaknesses.
That's what I'm coming to. The latest incident of a PIL containing allegations against judiciary going to one bench. That bench ordering the setting up of a constitution bench.
Mm.
And then the other bench, Chief Justice's bench, setting it aside. Give us your two-minute view, solely view, on what exactly happened. And what is the implication?
Well, what happened is this, that I think the judge who constituted the bench, really speaking, he did not have the power, really, because
Chalameshwar did not have the power, you think?
Chief Justice is the master of the roster.
Right.
But at the same time, there was no need for another bench to be constituted soon and his order to be nullified.
So if I get it right, Justice Chalameshwar was wrong to constitute this bench. He did not have the power. He should have deferred to the Chief Justice. But now that he had done it, Chief Justice need not have come and dismantled it.
It should have been resolved
by
themselves. Because what do the people think?
Right.
If the people think judges are not consistent in what they're doing. They want to wait in the judiciary. They go somewhere else to resolve the disputes.
This spectacle played out in public.
Yes, of course it did.
In full public view.
Yeah, unfortunate.
Unfortunately.
But the thing is, good points of the judiciary get downplayed.
They downplayed it. So, would you say who was more to blame in this? The first bench or the second bench?
Not to blame. Rather, they were both rather should have acted within certain constraints. They should have realized that the ultimate aim of the judiciary is to enforce the fundamental rights of the people, of the marginalized sections, of the indigent. That's the main. In that, if there are differences, resolve it. Don't do it openly.
But, Soli, then what is the solution? I'm putting myself on the other side now.
Yeah.
On the petitioner side in this. What is the solution if you think that there are serious allegations against judges? Who will judge the judges then?
Well, you know, first the theory was that a contempt petition. The truth is not a defense in contempt petition.
Right.
I was the Attorney General and I had an amendment made.
Yes.
Okay, no, truth is a defense.
Under Vajpayee government.
Truth in public
yes,
interest.
Truth was made a defense. Yes.
In public interest.
We all celebrated it.
In public interest.
Yes.
But in any case, truth in public interest is a defense. But in any case, even lawyers should be particular of allegations, I mean.
Right.
There should be some substance, some cohesion, credible evidence. You just can't go on making allegations.
You think in this case,
lawyers also are guilty of publicity.
The lawyers are guilty of publicity, you are saying. So in this case, did the lawyers who make this petition have any substantive facts or were they seeking publicity?
When they said they had facts, they were not allowed to present them. That was the unfortunate part. And then going out of the courts in a huff, and then some lawyers saying there should be contempt petition against that lawyer, Prashant Bhushan Kami,
right,
which I don't think is correct. We both have to work together, Shekhar.
But
the bench and the bar both together.
But
it's a joint endeavor.
Between Prashant Bhushan and the CJI, saying, charge me with contempt, you are beneath contempt.
Now, these things happen in court. People do get carried away. Shouldn't have happened,
but we are not
living in a ideal state of affairs. But all said in a shaker, the common man has still confidence in the judiciary.
Right.
Don't forget, any matter of public importance, they want a retired High Court or Supreme Court judge to head it.
But sometimes it's also done just to buy time because, you know, the report will never come out.
Neither.
Because most of these commissions go on forever.
No, not really. Some of them do. Some of them do because injunctions are granted that should not have been granted. So please devolve.
I mean, you know, our most famous case is Shah Commission. The report came, we can't find a copy now.
The Shah Commission report was actually regarded as a prohibited item.
Right, right. So, what will be your advice today? This CJI is going to be there for some time.
Yeah, yeah.
What will be your advice to him today to calm things down and to restore balance and sanity?
It's very presumptuous for me to give
advice. As I said, you are the
Chief Justice, but I like him.
You are
I
the lion king of the legal jungle.
No, lion top of the lion. Lion under the throne.
Dili ki English mein we say Lion King, but Lion King, yes.
No. Chief Justice was also take all his colleagues into confidence and resolve these issues between themselves. There's no use trying to score one or the other. Now, I don't think he'll do it. He's very reasonable, very temperate. Of course, he uses language which is a bit Johnsonese.
Right.
But
can you decode it?
There are some, you require a dictionary to decode it sometimes. But on the whole, he's a good person.
He's a good
who
person.
Has the citizens' rights.
And he's given some good rights.
Oh yes, no question about it. But Shekhar, as I said, we don't live in an ideal world.
Right.
And tomorrow, I would suggest that you be on the bench and I be on the bench and matters may be better.
I'll be a terrible lawyer.
But you're a better judge.
And a worse. I may enjoy being a judge because I can write 500 pages without anybody giving me a word limit.
That's not trouble. That's not trouble. There are two long judgments.
In my business, in journalism, there are word limits.
Take them as stenographers on the judges and make them write themselves. There'll be shorter judgments.
There'll be shorter judgments. So, Soli, That's your advice to CJI, that take everyone along, talk to them and restore calm. What is your advice to lawyers, particularly activist lawyers?
Well, to them the address is, don't make allegations unless you have cogent evidence. And don't get put off because a certain judge doesn't listen to you. You don't ask for a recusal because it's not agreeable with you.
Right.
It's like such a guy. You want everyone to be recused.
Is that being done? If you think the judge will not agree with me, you ask for a recusal?
It happens sometimes. That's unfortunate.
And that happened recently also.
I believe so.
Yeah. And Bilkar, I think.
If we take her, I think it's high time you went on the bench. And I was a lawyer arguing before you, then you'll pass correct orders.
I left college a long time back. I have no intention to going back to it. I don't have a law degree, but...
Don't require a law degree. Basic common sense and a feeling for the rights of the people,
right,
especially the downtrodden, the indigent, the marginalized.
Right. So, give me some examples where you think court has... You mentioned Sikh jokes, but I will mention some cases to you. The court intervention in BCCI, and now the takeover of BCCI, in two months, that takeover would have completed a year. An autonomous body has been taken over by the judiciary. Delhi Cricket Board has been taken over by the judiciary. I think Hyderabad is being taken over, and National Board has been taken over by judiciary. Retired judges are being appointed to run these. Is this a good idea?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
I don't think so. It gives the impression that the judges want to really appoint their own on certain bodies and they want to interfere. There are certain matters which are beyond the judicial ken, beyond the judicial sphere. And unless there's gross violation of any constitutional obligations, any statutory duties, the intervention should not be on account of dislike of policy decisions.